Hello everyone, here's another math video today about landlord revenue and profits. We have our average home price in thousands, our rent for, let's say, an average apartment, two bedroom, whatever. Property tax is removed, minus from the 1,000 here, because we want to get our landlord revenue or our landlord profits. This doesn't include mortgages, so it's a little vague. This is your annual return on investment. You just take your landlord revenue times 12 and then divide it into the 200,000 figure. You get 3.6% annual return on investment for the landlord. Our home ownership rate, this is taken off of the internet, 65%, meaning there are 34% rental units in America. This is the total amount of real estate asset value, $80 trillion. You just take 3.6% times 34%, because we only want the rental units, times 80 trillion, and you get about 1 trillion. The US annual GDP is 21 trillion. So you do the math, and that is 4.6% of GDP. And then I just threw this in here too. This is local, state, and federal spending is $8 trillion, which means that taxation is 812% more than rental profits. So this is just a really interesting little scenario here. If you increase this to 600,000, let's say you're in a liberal hellhole, 3,000, you're up to 6.6. And only 560%. So this has been modified down. The property tax is a much, much less. So if this was like, I think if it's kind of crazy in the liberal cities, 800 a month, 665%. So anyway, let's say that we have 60,000 apartments. No, this is our college. You might even get to like 40,000. And then this, we're pretty much taking a zero off. Then our property tax is going to be about 60. So 7% return on investment, 30% profits. This is confusing. The way I did the math is a little bit inaccurate, because if the average home price is lower, then the trillions of dollars of real estate would be lower, and then the rental income here would be lower, and then this would be lower. So this throws it off right here. This is assuming the average home price of like $160,000. So if it was actually $40,000, Arcology would be deflating the total real estate value in trillions of dollars, which affects this calculation, because we use this variable in this calculation, down to 2.3%, meaning taxation is that much higher. Now, I could get taxable income in Arcology versus taxable income per resident in the United States. I believe this is $2,400 a month here, and then in Arcology it's like $400 a month, something like that. So that's six times less, and you take $1,600 divided by six, would get you what, 300%, something like that. I don't know if you lost me there, but this would be for Arcology. This is more of the Arcology flavor. Yeah. Honestly, this might even get down to 200, who knows? 2,700. Wow. Anyway, that's it for this quick mathematics video. I hope it was enlightening for you, and hopefully we can get down to these numbers with Arcology. Thank you, and have a nice day. If you want to see a new and better world come to fruition, as I do, then like, share, and subscribe. You can find an incredible amount of math, knowledge, and 3D renders by clicking on the channel name. And remember, we need you to help spread this vision across the internet for all to see and become familiar with. Let us build this new world together.